Alright, so we're back with another video. This time we're flying the Talon GT Rebel. And it's going to be a little bit more interesting than usual because I faced some issues, which you'll see coming up here shortly. And obviously I'm outside launching the airplane right now. And what you might notice in my FPV feed is that my video transmitter is dying. It still seems to be transmitting as if you look through the static, and I'm not sure how it's going to come out once YouTube recompresses video and everything. It's probably going to kill it. But in the raw native video anyway, I can see part of the image is still there. It's just my receivers are not picking it up. But when I actually launched the airplane, obviously I was outside launching the airplane and flew it a bit line of sight and got into the altitude hold and stabilized mode, whatever. And by the time I got back into my shop to start flying via FPV, the feed was back. So I didn't notice that there was a problem. So as far as I'm concerned, everything is still normal. So, in my last video, I had the Foxeer Mix on a 3D printed pan and tilt, and I actually kind of changed up the design a little bit from that pan and tilt to fit an older a Runcam Split Mini, the two-board version of the small split, and that's what I'm using for this flight. And that was the goal of this flight, was to test fly and try that out, and see I'm doing that now. It works well. I do want to kind of change the tilt. The pan axis a little bit, raise the front of the servo up a little bit more level, but anyway, that's kind of beside the point. So like I said, the purpose of this flight was just to try out the different camera and see how it worked and if it was any better than the Foxeer mix, and I did like it. I was pretty happy with it. The FPV feed is again, it's typical of these little kind of split style cameras. Well, this one is a split, but it's not the best, but it's serviceable, it's workable, and the HD is decent. It's a 1080 60 recording and kind of medium grade, mid-range quality, I would say. It's not as good as GoPro or something like that, obviously, but considering the size and weight, I do like these little camera setups. So as you can see, I'm out just flying around, kind of enjoying the plane, flying out over the water, which the water is receding a little bit. It is dropping some. The water level in the river has fallen a little bit, so the waters are receding a bit. But it is already on the rise. This flight actually took place on Sunday, and I'm editing the video on Tuesday. So between that time, the river has actually back on the rise again. So we're expecting some more water back in here over the next couple of weeks or so, I would guess. But anyway, I'm just kind of giving you a little bit of information just kind of as a filler here. So like I said, I did leave this entire flight completely uncut and unedited, other than overlaying the FPV feed over the HD recording and obviously the voiceover. But getting back to the issue that you're gonna see here coming up, well, you already saw it, but I wasn't aware of it yet, and I'm still not sure why, but my video transmitter, the one in this airplane, has started to just randomly drop the feed like you saw at the launch there. And you'll see that coming up in a bit here once we get back over the trees up ahead of us a bit. It was actually the first time I lost video while I was flying. And I have done a little bit of testing and troubleshooting on the ground, and you know, after this flight obviously, but I'm not sure why it's doing it. It runs for a few minutes and then starts dropping the feed, and it goes in and out kind of in a cycle. And I'm not sure if it's the PLL circuit, which is a phase lock loop, which is what sets the frequency and holds it, or the voltage regulator inside. There's a 5-volt regulator in this transmitter, and I'm thinking maybe it's dropping the voltage or something and throwing things off, which I may look further into it later, but probably not. I'm just going to trash it and replace it. But as you can see here, I've actually lost the feed again, and I'm in RTH mode now, so the airplane's flying itself, and you might have noticed the static blacked out there for just a bit and came back. I actually cycled the power on my receivers and diversity controller. I use the Eagle Eyes from Eagle Tree as a diversity controller, and that didn't help, so now you see the feed has come back on its own, just randomly came right back. So you see I'm still in return to home mode at the moment. So I kind of assessed the situation and decided to switch back into altitude hold, which stabilized mode that I was flying in previously, and kind of started playing around with the pan and tilt again. Now, the plan was still to head back home and land and go ahead and end the flight before, you know, something else went wrong. I wasn't really sure what was wrong, so I decided I should get it back on the ground and check things out. But along the way, you can see I was kind of playing around with the pan and tilt again and just kind of feeling the camera out and the pan and tilt, and she'll see coming up here in just a second. There it goes. The video dropped out again. So at this point, I centered the camera, the pan and tilt, and I switched back into return to home mode and actually walked outside. And I could hear the airplane, but I couldn't really spot it yet. And when I did spot it, shortly hereafter, it was just a little speck. It was too far away to really gauge the orientation of the airplane. So I let the autopilot fly at home, which is iNav, by the way, which you probably already saw by the OSD or know from previous videos on this one. But it is iNav on the Wing 405 board from Matek. So I just let it fly home until it got close enough. And you'll probably notice when the nose drops, I had actually, once the airplane was close enough, I felt I could, I was confident that I could fly it line of sight. I went ahead and switched back to angle mode and cut the power, and I started losing altitude and doing some S-turns and this and that, which you can see now on the OSD. I'm back in angle mode and the power is cut. You can see that by the amp draw. Here's those S-turns I was talking about. I was kind of getting a feel for the airplane, what it actually looks like in the air, flying it line of sight, and how, you know, it looks orientation-wise. Because I've actually never flown this airplane line of sight until now. It's strictly FPV. And there goes the video again. Like I said, it just kind of randomly drops in cycles, and maybe you can make out part of the image there. It's still there in the static, but at this point I was still outside flying line of sight, and you can see I didn't really line up on my runway as well as I'd hoped. I was just happy to get it back down and on the ground and did a nice smooth line of sight landing, and that was it. And so that's where we're at. This one is going to be grounded until I replace the video transmitter, which, as you can see, it has dropped the feed again. It just kind of repeats that cycle. I've never seen one do this. And by the way, I haven't mentioned it yet. This is the Partom branded, P-A-R-T-O-M. They're sold by various Chinese shops and retailers, and several in the United States used to carry them. They're a little bit harder to find in the United States now. Ready-made RC is one that still carries this series of transmitters. This one is the 200 milliwatt version, and I also fly the 400s and 800s. I have a 1500 in my Skyhunter, and I've used several of these, and I've never actually lost one in the air. I've had a couple of the 800s die on the ground, but they usually die at when you power the plane up. Just one day there's no transmission anymore. So I think they die at power up randomly. I have a couple of them on my bench that I saved that did die like that, and I may investigate those. Maybe it's the 5-volt regulator is what I'm thinking. But if I end up diagnosing this any further, I'll maybe do a video on it. But for now, the plan is to get on with the binary build, because that actually has arrived, so you can expect some videos coming up from that soon. And I guess we'll go ahead and end the video now, and hope it was somewhat interesting and enjoyable, and keep an eye out for us to come. And of course, thank you to everybody that watches the video, subscribes, thumbs up, thumbs down, whatever, comments, and of course the Patreons and people that use the affiliate links as usual. So see you all in the next one.